leading to a cost saving, and this is very impressive. I request through you, respected Speaker, that all members present here listen to what saving, cost saving has emerged because of the LED bulbs. Approximately 35 crore LED bulbs have been distributed under the Ujala Yojana, leading to a cost saving of 18,341 crores annually, every year, because of LED. This is what the country is saving. It is going to be free of incandescent. India is going to be free of incandescent bulbs, and CFL use has already become minuscule. We will use the approach of Mission LED bulb method to promote the use of solar stoves and battery chargers in the country. To make railway travel a pleasant and satisfying experience to the common citizen, again, ease of living, we will launch a massive program of railway station modernization this year. Railway station modernization will be launched this year. Honorable Speaker, sir, I draw the attention to the women of India. Nari to Narayani. We believe, obviously, this country's tradition has been Nari to Narayani. Swami Vivekananda, in a letter to Swami Ramakrishnananda, had said, there's no chance for the welfare of the world unless the condition of women is improved. I repeat, there is no chance for the welfare of the world unless the condition of women is improved. It is not possible. It is not possible for a bird to fly on one wing. Swami Vivekananda's words. This government believes that we can make progress with greater women's participation. In India's growth story, sir, I would like to draw your attention. In India's growth story, particularly in the rural economy, Grameen Arthvyavastha mein, the role of women is a very sweet story. Grameen Arthvyavastha mein mahila ki bhagidari ekdam ek sunera kahani. This government wishes to encourage and facilitate the role of women. Gender analysis of the budget aimed at examining the budgetary allocation through a gender lens has been in place for over a decade. I propose to form a broad-based committee with government and private stakeholders to evaluate and suggest action for moving forward. There is no segment of human life where the contribution of women is not significant. There is no segment where the contribution of women is not significant. This government firmly believes that the socio-economic transformation that is taking place, particularly in the last decade, India's women's role and leadership is distinct. The recent elections have shown record turnout of women voters at par with men. Record turnout of women voters at par with men. We also have a record number of 78 women MPs here in this house. This reinforces our approach of going beyond just women-centric policy. I repeat, this reinforces our approach of going beyond just women-centric policy making to building women-led initiatives and movements. This government, Speaker Sir, has supported and encouraged women entrepreneurship through various schemes such as Mudra, Stand Up India, self-help group support, and so on. In order to further encourage women enterprises, I propose to expand the Women SHG interest subvention program to all districts in India. Furthermore, for every verified woman SHG member having a Jan Dhan bank account, for every verified woman SHG member having a Jan Dhan account, an overdraft of 5,000 shall be allowed. Again, one woman in every SHG, which is spread all across the country, one woman in every SHG will also be made eligible for a loan up to 1 lakh under the Mudra scheme. Speaker, sir, at the beginning I did tell you about India's soft power. India's soft power, which is the next section I'll concentrate on, India's soft power is appreciated in so many different ways. Some simple examples, sir. In the last 3 years, on the International Yoga Day, yoga has been practiced in large numbers in 192 countries around the world. Mahatma Gandhi's favorite bhajan, Vaishnava Janto Tene Kahiye, was sung by the respective lead artists from over 40 countries. The annual Bharat Ko Jano quiz competition is sought after as an event to participate by not only NRIs, non-resident Indians, but also several foreigners themselves. I propose to consider issuing Aadhaar card for non-resident Indians with Indian passports after their arrival in India without waiting for 180 days. I repeat it. I propose to consider issuing Aadhaar cards for non-resident Indians with Indian passports after their arrival in India without waiting for the mandatory 180 days, without waiting the issue. I propose to launch a mission which will integrate our traditional artisans and their creative products with global markets. Wherever necessary, we shall obtain patents for them and the geographical indicators, GI, for them. I wish to say this in Hindi for the larger audience of traditional artisans. Is uddeshya se, main is garima mai prangan se, pehli baar yah goshna karti hun ki hum Bharat ke srijanatmak udyogon ko अर्थव्यवस्था से जोड़कर जहां आवश्यक है बौद्धिक संपदा अधिकारों से संरक्षित करके राष्ट्रीय और अंतर्राष्ट्रीय बाजार तक पहुंचाने की मुहिम प्रारंभ करेंगे। Impetus to India's growing influence and leadership in the international community, government decided to open Indian embassies and high commissions abroad in countries where India does not have a resident diplomatic mission as yet. Accordingly, in March 2018, government approved opening of 18 new Indian diplomatic missions in Africa. 5 embassies have already been opened in Rwanda, Djibouti, Equatorial Guinea, Republic of Guinea and Burkina Faso in the year 2018-19. Government intends to open another 4 embassies, new ones, in the year 2019-20. This will not only increase the footprint of India's overseas presence, but also enable us to provide better and more accessible public services, especially to the local Indian communities in these countries. In line with our ancient wisdom, India has always pursued a policy of economic cooperation with countries through bilateral and regional coordination. Indian Development Assistance Scheme, IDEAS, provides concessional financing for projects and contributes to infrastructure development and capacity building in the recipient developing countries. mindful of our position as the sixth largest economy, we will look at alternative development models which include private sector equity, multilateral financing, contributions from corporates, non-residents, and so on. I propose to revamp the IDEA scheme during the current financial year. The government is developing 17 iconic tourism sites into world-class tourist destinations and to serve as a